how to select the best water pump for your aquaponics system. This is what we're going to see together in this video today. But just before, please subscribe to the channel, and if you haven't done it yet, get the free aquaponics guide from the description of this video. It's a free training to help you to build your own aquaponics system, but also to produce sustainable, healthy, and tasty food in your own backyard. Hello, this is Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics, and today we're going to see how to select the best aquaponics water pump for your setup. So I already made some video in the past about water pumps, what is the good size for your setup. And if you haven't watched them, I really recommend you to have a look at this video. But right now, what I want to discuss is not really the size of the pump, but the type of pump that you need to use for your setup. And there are some aspects to check in the water pumps. You know, you're going to have different ranges of pumps, some good quality and some bad quality. And what I want to discuss with you today is what is a quality water pump and what is a poor quality water pump. So there are two types of pumps that are quite different. The centrifugal pump, they work with this force. You know, when you turn a wheel, you are always pushed outside of the rotation. And this is basically helping the water to go through some pipes. So that's most of the pumps that we use in aquaponics. And those pumps, they are able to basically move a very large water flow with a very limited quantity of energy. On the other side, the positive displacement water pump are more adapted to a lower water flow, but with a higher pressure. So in aquaponics, most of the time, we want to raise the water from the fish tank level or from the sump tank level to the grow bed. So sometimes you got 1 meter, sometimes you got 50 centimeters. In some very small backyard aquaponics systems, we got 50 centimeters most of the time. But sometimes it can go up to 2 meters. Very rarely, we have to do 10 meters, 20 meters. And I think for aquaponics, the best pumps, the most adapted, are the centrifugal pumps. So they look like this. You see, that's one of them. This one is 1,400 liters per hour, but that's the maximum capacity of the pump. So when you read the capacity of a pump, they're going to tell you what is the maximum water flow that it can produce. So that's if you don't raise the water above the level of the fish tank. But then, if you go above, then the quantity, the water flow decrease. So if this pump is 1,400 liters per hour of maximum water flow, you can imagine that once it's at 1 meter, it's going to be divided by almost maybe 800, it's going to be maybe 800 liters. I mean, normally when you buy a pump, you can see a curve, and it gives you basically for each height that you want to raise the water level, you want to raise the water, it's going to give you the specific water flow for the pump at this specific height. So those types of pumps, 1,400 liters, they are particularly well adapted to backyard aquaponics, such as the one I have behind me, a 1,000 liter setup. And again, if you want to know exactly how to know the best pump for your system, have a look at the free aquaponics training that is in the description of this video. So that's what I recommend, centrifugal pumps for aquaponics if you are working with backyard aquaponics systems such as the one I have behind me. Now we got different types of pumps. So you see this one is quite interesting, it's quite large, but we got smaller ones that are looking like this. So this one is 1,000 liters per hour. And also, what you can read on the pump is the power, that is the power consumption. So this one is 20 watts, and this one is 18.5 watts. So you see this one already is more efficient than this small one, but is moving more water. So you see the two pumps, they look the same. You could think that one is has more capacity, so it's going to consume more electricity. But in reality, when you read the specs of the pump, the specification of the pump, you realize that one pump has more capacity and it's using less power than the other one. So straight away, you can see that there is a difference between those two pumps that are both centrifugal pumps. And what is interesting is that there are some very big differences that we can see here. This one is sucking the water from the bottom here, but this one is sucking the water from the side. And you can see there is a large panel. So it's really good because in aquaponics, one of the work you will have to do, the maintenance, is to check that the pump is still working correctly and is not clogged. You know, there is no too many fins that are clogged on the pump. You know, sometimes you have some leaves or whatever that are clogged here, and the pump is not working correctly. If you see that the outlet water flow is reducing, it means that here you have something that is clogging. And if you don't clean the pump after a while, the pump is going to start to use a lot of force to try to suck the water, and it's going to damage the equipment. So it's important to clean your pump quite regularly. Here you can see another difference, then that's the area of suction, where the pump is able to suck the water. So the larger the area, and the better it is. So we're going to open these pumps. So this one is completely new. This one has been used, and I want to show you what happened on a poor quality pump that has been used for a few months or a year. So let's open them. So this one, inside you got access to the rotor. So it's here. I just open this. Yeah. And here we got the rotor. So here we have the rotor. Oh, there is a little seal that I don't want to lose. That is here. So I put them together. But what is very interesting on this pump is the axis. So you know that's the axis of the pump. And here I will try to get it. Yes, I do have it. You see, it's white. And this axe is ceramic, actually. So ceramic is very hard. You can break it, but it's not going to be altered with the time. You know, because you got a friction between this part here, the rotor, that is turning around this axe. And after a while, in some pumps, you got this axe here that is used, and it decreases in diameter. And after a while, it's broken. You can't use it anymore. So on ceramic parts, this part here is not going to be used, and it can run for years and years and years. So that's a very important thing. Now, if we have a look at a classic pump such as this one. So this one has been used for several months, right? So we're going to have a quick look at how it looks inside. So same principle, you see, you got the axe and you got the rotor that is around, that is turning around. But now if we have a look at the axe, I remove the rotor, and here you can see that the shape of this axe is completely used. Those two pieces, they are turning against each other and they use each other. So this one has a very, very limited lifetime when it's in metal. And if you buy a pump with a metal axis, most of the time after a few months, you will have to basically renew the pump. Well, if you buy a pump with ceramic, such as this one, you can go for years. And this pump is going to stay still very, very efficient. So also the other thing is, here we have less friction on the ceramic, because ceramic is so, it's like glass, you know, it's very smooth. So there is a very low friction when the rotor is turning around the ceramic. While on the other one, on the metal one, you get a lot of friction between the two elements. That's why this one is consuming more power and is less powerful in terms of water flow, while the other one is consuming less power and is generating a higher water flow. So obviously in aquaponics we want to be sustainable, and because we want to be sustainable, we want to make sure we buy a quality pump that is going to use a less power for the water movement that we want to generate. If you want to find a good pump for your aquaponics system, first get the free aquaponics guide from the description of this video just below. It's a free training. In this training, you're going to find the exact size water pump that you need for your aquaponics system. So it's going to give you basically the water flow that you need to generate for your aquaponics system. From there, buy a water pump with what I recommend, with a ceramic axe. And thanks to this ceramic one, you're going to be able to have a very efficient aquaponic system that consumes a very low power consumption, and that is going to produce sustainable food, because obviously you need less power to generate the same quantity of food. So it's going to be sustainable and interesting from an economical point of view. Obviously, when you buy the pump, those ones are slightly more expensive than the classic ones that are with metal axes, but it makes a very significant difference, and also it's well longer in the lifetime. So you can spend twice the price on those ones, and they're gonna basically consume less energy, and they're gonna last way longer. So that's all for today, for this short video. I hope you learned a few things, and I hope it's gonna help you to select the good water pump in order to get very sustainable and produce some very healthy food in your own backyard. I see you in the next video. Bye-bye. If you are watching this video on YouTube, you will see that on the description of the video just below, you will have access to some free gifts. First, you have access to a six-step process to be able to build your own aquaponic system in good conditions. I developed this six-step process because I found that too many beginners are basically starting aquaponics with a wrong design. So if you want to build your own aquaponics setup, please just follow this six-step process. It's completely free, right? I redesigned it to help you to build your setup in good conditions and therefore to succeed in aquaponics. So once you get access to the free training, you will arrive to this page. And here you will have a detail of different steps. And each time you got a video or some description to really allow you to build some strong knowledge and to know and to learn the basics of aquaponics, so to avoid any mistakes. So just enter your email address and you will receive access to this training. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon. And I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop! So, you know, when you buy a water pump, you're going to have different types of pump, and it's classified in two big types. So you got a very wide quantity of types of water pump, but you got the water pumps that are called centrifugal. They work with the centrifugal force, and you got the other pumps, the pumps that we call the pumps that are called positive displacement water pumps.